south of the county. What does a Yorkshireman know about it? Ah, you may well ask. But the answer's simple. I've lived in Lancashire for most of my life, and I wear ever such a pale pink rose in a buttonhole most of the time. Except, of course, when Yorkshire play Lancashire. Then it's a bit tricky-like to make up my mind. But back to Sarah. Sarah works in a mill like thousands of others, but she doesn't wear gloves and shawl anymore. A scarf round her head, certainly, but no gloves and no shawl. Talking of these scarves, I often wonder how hat shops make a living around here. No one seems to wear them. Oh, sorry, lady. No offense. Lady Sarah lives in Oldham, hard by Manchester, where pit and mill live side by side. The big square mills with their tall chimneys are apparently all built to the same design. The stacks tower above everything, belching out smoke and dirt, which blackens all it touches. The first thing that strikes a traveller from more rural areas is the pitch blackness of things, even the churches. Where there's muck, there's money, they say. Certainly there's muck in plenty in South Lancashire. The house is the same wherever you go, be it Salford, Bolton, or Blackburn, or anywhere else. Memorials to the misery and suffering which the Industrial Revolution brought to this country. The children play in shut-off streets, robbed of the green freshness which should be their birthright. But let's get back to Sarah, our lassie from Lancashire. After all, it's what she's used to. As she walks back from the mill to her little home, she will be thinking not so much of her surroundings as of Harry and the things that will do when he gets back home. She will have no eyes for some of the wonders around her,